Hey guys, I'm Krim. Welcome to a new video. This is another episode of Krim's Randomness. What are we gonna do today? Well, today I wanna build with you my practice setup. To be honest, I have done it before, but all the hardware that I used was pretty crappy and wobbly, and I thought like I have to do it again. And a lot of people have asked me what I use, so I will show you what I need, and everything is lined up here nicely. Let's check it out. So I will use a bunch of pads. We have here the big Charbreaker pad. It is pretty beaten up because it's my old one. It's like 10 years old. Then we have three small ones, which are really cool because we can mount them on the cymbal stands. Then we got a bunch of Meindl cymbal mute pads, which are also very cool. Got a lot of hardware here. And of course we need some cymbals. I will use the dynamic kick pad from Meindl. Don't worry, this is just a sock. It is not how it comes. I just pimped it a little bit. All the double bass madness and hard hitting. I want that it's, you know, sustaining for a long time. So I put some extra protection on there. Of course, we also need a pedal. I'm gonna use my old Charger Cubita pedal with the colorful beaters. So these are the new ones. And we're gonna set everything up on this Charbreaker carpet. So it's gonna be legit Charbreaker overload. We have the carpet Charbreaker. We got all the pads here in front of a Charbreaker flag. It's gonna be sick. Don't worry, I will list everything that I use in the description so you can check it out later. And now I will mount you on my chest mount and then we're gonna start building it. I wanna start first with the pad for the kick. We tried to line it up kinda right in front of the bigger drum kit. I think that should be nice. Then let's get our pedal. A cool trick to line up your pedals is use a drumstick so you can kind of see if they're straight or in a straight line. That kind of looks cool. Perfect. Make sure everything is where it's supposed to be. This pad is pretty cool, you know, the dynamic pad, because you can adjust the height of the legs, you can adjust the pad like moving closer to the beater or further away, you can adjust the height of it, so that's pretty awesome. Next, let's get our snare stand. It is the low version of the snare stand. I'm pretty small, and if you have a big fat snare drum, it is really useful to have a low stand, but I don't know how it's gonna work with the pad. Let's see. So for the snare, we're gonna use, as I said, my old Charbreaker pad. I got it when I joined with Meindl, so 10 years ago. And there's the failed attempt of me trying to put a nut inside to mount it also on a cymbal stand, but of course it didn't work. So we're gonna just do it in a classic way. We just mount it on a snare stand. Keep the space free here for like a rimshot area. So I might wanna twist it a bit more. Exactly, so here that I can kind of imitate a rimshot. It's a bit low for me. We'll see if we can tighten this a bit. That should work. So next up, we're going to take the hi-hat stand. Nice. Ta-da-ta-ta. We're getting there. We're getting there. So we need a hi-hat. Let's use the pure alloy. Just the bottom. Perfect. Next up, we're gonna need this here. It is specifically for the hi-hat. So it goes in between. And for the top, we have another pad. Because it's pretty cool. We have them in all kinds of different sizes. So this would be an 18-inch. 16 inch, and there's also a 20 inch in there, but we're gonna use only two cymbals. This goes on the top because we're gonna play on it. I will adjust the height afterwards. Now I wanna do a basic setup so it feels like everything is kind of where it's supposed to be, and then the fine tuning comes later. So I got a bunch of, you know, like, what are they called? Fast clamps attachment. Really not a lot of stuff on the floor. More or less everything is mounted together like a Christmas tree. Let me see. Okay, this would be the symbol stand for the crash. I'm gonna use only two crashes. All right, something like this. We're gonna take the 16 inch one, and we're gonna have also a 16 inch crash over there. So you just place this, let's look at that. Yeah, that will kind of do for now. So let's have a closer look at these guys. They are pretty fresh, as you can see. So we don't need the felt on it. So we're gonna unscrew it, and also we're not going to need the screw. Because the cool thing about these Tribreaker pads, or in general the 6-inch pads for Meinl, is that you got a nut in here, and we can screw it on the cymbal arm. It's pretty cool, you know. You can take it on the road, you can you know, set it up at home, or you can even build like a drum kit with that. And this is what we're doing right now. So this would be our first tom. Nice. That's cool. Probably needs to go down a little bit, but for now it's awesome. We're gonna take care of those because we can need them later on. Then we're gonna take another stand. This is gonna be for our 18 inch right cymbal, which is not a right cymbal, but you know, we're gonna say it's a right cymbal. Touchdown. It's also pretty cool that you can, you know, of course you can play on the rubber surface, but if you want to have a little bit more ping, you can do it also here on the metal, and of course it won't be as loud as if you have no dampening on it. Hi-hat, crash, it's gonna be tom, 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 right, or we can kind of also see it as some sort of right crash thing if we mount it a bit higher. And then we're gonna try to mount a tom from here and another floor tom over there. Nice. So we're gonna use the same one for the tom number 2, which we want to kind of simulate a 12 inch tom. That's nice. That's really nice. And the last one for our floor tom. And then I'm doing the fine tuning, and then I will take a, we're gonna make like a tour through the drum kit, a close-up tour. But we're almost done. You know, it's pretty cool how quick you can set it up. And then you got a super nice practice setup. You wonder why I'm gonna, you know, use a practice setup instead of the real drum kit in front of me. To be honest, it's pretty cool to, you know, like warm up, to work on techniques, to learn songs, because it's not as loud as the real drums. You're not distracted as much, you know, with like a real drum kit. And it's just for exercising basic movements. Super nice. That's really cool. That's really nice. Would be easier if I take off what I have in my hand. This one needs to be a bit tighter now. Good, now everything's kind of basic setup. I will do the fine tuning, and then we go through this kit in detail with a bunch of close-up shots. Alright guys, that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Maybe it inspired you to build your own practice set. So what is left? Well, let me play a little bit on the set and I'm gonna see you in the next video. Take care of you, bye bye. Thank you.